Well, you've probably heard about the $2 or 3 trillion that U.S. companies have stashed away in their foreign subsidiaries, and they're unwilling to bring it back because if they do so, they'll have to pay tax. Many argue that if we give corporations a lower tax rate or an incentive to repatriate those profits and bring them home, it'll lead to a surge in investment and hiring. So first of all, no one thinks it's good policy to allow U.S. companies to accumulate trillions of dollars untaxed in their foreign subsidiaries. And if tax reform accomplishes anything, it will eliminate that practice. But we shouldn't expect the repatriation of that income to lead to a lot of job creation or investment here at home, because most of that cash is already invested right here in the United States. Don't take it from me. You can look at the annual financial statements of the companies that hold all of that cash. For instance, Microsoft states that 92% of its overseas cash is actually invested in U.S. assets. Assets like U.S. Treasury bonds, asset-backed securities, U.S. corporate bonds. And so what that means is all of that income is actually invested in our financial system, and through our financial system, it's making loans to homebuyers and helping to grow domestic businesses. Here's the thing. Repatriating that cash is not going to boost investment or create jobs here in the United States. So why the misunderstanding? Well, partly because words like unrepatriated and overseas don't necessarily refer to geography. Instead, they're accounting terms that determine when and why a corporation becomes liable to pay tax on its overseas income. All that repatriation would accomplish is moving the cash from the bank accounts of the corporation to the bank accounts of the shareholders. And while that's good for shareholders, it's not going to increase the total amount of investment in the economy. In 2004, companies brought back hundreds of billions of dollars in unrepatriated cash, but it didn't create jobs and didn't create investment. It was paid out as dividends to shareholders. So it's not like it's stashed in a mattress in France. If the money's already here, why should we give companies a tax break for something that would only benefit their shareholders? Well, we shouldn't. A better approach is to impose the full rate of tax that other companies pay on those untaxed earnings. We should use that revenue to pay for things that actually benefit the American worker.